What is up, guys? My name is Flares, and welcome back to the final recording session of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. Now, I'm going to explain a few things really quick before we actually get into the bulk of this recording. First thing is, I did promise that we were going to actually get Ultima Weapon in this Let's Play, as well as fight all of the secret bosses. There's been a slight change to that. First of all, I will get Ultima Weapon, just not in the main part of this Let's Play, because in this game, Ultima Weapon is super annoying to get. It's going to take me like hours upon hours upon hours, and I would love to show you guys the end of this game before, you know, like Kingdom Hearts 2.5 HD comes out. And hopefully I can get Kingdom Hearts 1.5 HD before 2.5 HD comes out, because then I can show you guys Rechain and the day's cutscenes and all that stuff. And as far as the secret bosses, I will do those in bonus episodes when I have the, I guess you could say, assets to do them. Because I'm going to have to level up a lot. I don't have to get Ultima Weapon to beat the secret bosses. I mean, there's people that beat the secret bosses with the Kingdom Key. But I need to, you know, study up on secret bosses so I don't get my ass royally handed to me. But without further ado, let's head on the final world. I want to point something out here. So, Hollow Bastion here, which is now sealed, by the way. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 stars in its battle level. This one has 10. This is the most difficult world in the game. Off we go. It's also, I believe, like I said in the previous recording, probably like an episode of, like 3 episodes ago maybe. I don't know how many episodes that last recording got split up into, because this is being recorded the same day! Woo! But I said that this is like the shortest gummy ship mission in the game, and I believe that holds true. And if it doesn't, then shame on me. I like how much power I have. But I have, like, no armor. Look at this. We are actually descending into the Realm of Darkness here. That's what's going on here. We are going through the gummy routes into the lanes between... Or, what am I saying? We're going into the Realm of Darkness here. So, like I said back in Hollow Bastion, Hollow Bastion is, like, in the realms between... is how I put it. Basically, this is like us heading into the Realm of Darkness. We are confronting Ansem in his own playing field. And as you will see when we get there, it does confirm to us that it is in the Realm of Darkness, which you will see as we head through that world, as well as when we get to the very end of that world. I don't want to, you know, spoil anything. I've been good about not spoiling parts of the series here. But, yeah, it's exciting, isn't it? Now, see, if I actually spent the time of actually doing gummy ship stuff like I had promised, yeah, we'd actually be getting through this a bit faster, because now that I have the complete gummy kit from the Dalmatians, I could actually, like, throw a bunch of boosters. Oh my god. Get my ass handed to me here. Yeah. So, the end of the world, which is the final world that we are going to be... we are heading to. I know I spoiled the name, my bad. It's a cool place, I have to say. It just kind of makes you feel like I've made it. This is it. This is the end. And we should be coming... we're coming across it right now. There it is. See? A nice, simple gummy ship mission. Maybe not the shortest in the game, but it, compared to what we've dealt with previously, it felt shorter. Alright, end of the world. Let's disembark.
gosh, is that all that's left of the worlds taken by the Heartless?
Those worlds will be restored if we beat Ansem, right?
You betcha!
But if we do beat him, and all these worlds become restored and disconnected, what's gonna happen to this place? And to us?
This is a Heartless world, so maybe it'll just disappear.
Huh?
But no worries. Even if this place goes poof, our hearts ain't going nowhere. I'm sure we'll find our pals again. Yep, I just know that we will.
Yeah, you're right. I'll return this. I promise.
Even if it takes another year. I didn't say that. All right. Really quick. Oblivion is the Keyblade we will be using for the rest of the game. As far as accessories go, I do want to have my AP pretty much maxed out here. But we're going to switch over to the Mega Arts. Let's see what else can we... We'll put this Heart Guard on. I know I'm, like, destroying the amount of AP I have. What else can I do? I can drop my MP for more defense. That would be useful. Alright, that seems to be good enough for now. Let's see if we can put anything better on Donald. Anything? Doesn't look like it. I think this Protega chain's about as good as it's gonna get. Yeah. Sandaga ring, that's gonna be as good as it gets. Wait, what is that? All elemental damage. We'll throw that on. Even though it would be useful to have the Dark Ring as opposed to anything else. Anyway. Abilities. I have one AP left. Oh yeah, I had a bunch of like AP ups and stuff that I had gathered through the journey. I guess... I have a lot of abilities now, but as I was saying, I had a lot of AP ups that we gathered on our journey. It was like two, actually, and I gave them both to Sora. I also gave defense ups and strength ups to Sora. What is this? Boost attack power when HP is critically low. See, all this stuff is good. Everything I have on here is good. We won't need Lucky Strike anymore. So we can put Ragnarok on. That's really all I wanted was Ragnarok, because Ragnarok is cool. It's cool. Anything else? I guess Lucky Strike on you, and then Jackpot. What? Oh, it needs two, so we'll put Cheer. I'm like, what? Goofy, you have five left, so we'll give you Berserk. Oh, I want you to have MP Gift. I'm gonna take off this treasure magnet for MP haste. Alright. What I do want to do, and I've been meaning to do this the entire LP actually, is turn vibration off. Anything else? Auto lock, target lock, camera. Yeah. That's all good. So, I'm actually going to go back in here because save point. There we go. We can heal up a bit. Good stuff going on there. Alright. So, there's actually invisible walls here. And we will be thrust into another part of the world, which is actually the part of the world we're in, to fight a bunch of Heartless. It's quite an interesting concept, really. I guess I can show off Ragnarok. There you go. That's what Ragnarok looks like. Uses up a lot of MP, though. So I won't be using it too often, hopefully. I don't know why I might. Anyway, I'm going to shut up for a bit so you can listen to the music, because it's some pretty damn good music. Get a power up. So as you will notice, the platforms are actually in the shape of triangles. And by opening up, I believe every single one of these chests will actually have a battle in it. We're not going to be opening up all the chests just because I don't need everything. I just wanted to show that this is what happens when you go to open a chest. I was also kind of like, what's in this chest? Also, it gives me more reason to show off Ragnarok, because it's pretty, and you don't get to use Ragnarok in, like, Kingdom Hearts 2. It's weird. Why am I mumbling? Oh yeah, also, I was supposed to say this at the beginning of the recording, but, never mind, it's not important. So I'm not going to bother with the chest, because we can actually just end up running through this instead. Because there are no more items that we need to technically have 100% in this game. I'm counting 100% as getting the secret ending. And to get the secret ending, you only need to get to steal all of the keyholes. That's the most important part. And that's in expert mode. That's all you have to do. In normal mode, which is what I'm playing in, and which is why I had such an easy time getting through the game. In normal mode, you need to beat the Hades Cup, which we did in the last episode. And you need to rescue all 99 puppies to get the secret ending. That's all you have to do. That's why I didn't bother going back for Trinities and stuff. I think I have to go all the way over to this one. And there's probably one more battle before we're done in this area. I thought there was, anyway. Yeah, there is. I was going to say, I remember fighting a Bahamut in this area. A Bahamut? Bahamut! There he is. Oh, look at that. Right on cue, man. At least it's not as tough as the one we had to fight in the Hades Cup, right? Ragnarok is not as helpful as I was hoping it would be. Maybe Strike Raid will. Who knows? I don't. Can't believe we're here, though. End of the world, man. End of the world. It is quite the place. Oh man, get out of there. Let's strike raid this guy. And there we go! Heal up here, grab our money and MP orbs and all that stuff. Good stuff, good stuff. I wonder where that Ansem feller went. Dive into the most dangerous place and we'll find him. Alright, so I have to remember the deal with this place, because if I remember correctly, there are a lot of items around here, and you can't exactly travel up. Excuse me. Maybe there were no items. I don't even know. Just look at this place. It's kind of crazy. There's an item over there. What's in here? I can't carry any more Ultima G's. Yeah, that's not a surprise. It's probably like all gummy ship stuff anyway. Oh, there's a save point there. I don't even think I ever realized there was a save point down here. Huh. I thought there was only two save points here. See, we can't even leave the world. That's kind of crazy, right? Kind of nuts. So we're on 5, and yeah, I'm just not even going to worry about saving till we get to the very end. All right, this is going to be fun. Trust me.